Surgeon General is issuing a call to action.
Yes, it's aimed at parents, teachers, and health professionals who deal with teenagers. Let's go to health reporter Haley Hernandez. She's got our health headlines.
Good morning, guys. So the Surgeon General's actually in Houston today to talk about this, among some other topics. Surgeon General Dr. Jerome Adams has put out the very first advisory ever on e-cigarettes in youth. He says one out of five high school students currently use the product, and it's spreading to younger teens and children. One survey reported a 50% increase in vaping among middle school-aged children. Adams says no amount of nicotine is safe for developing brains, and he warns the epidemic of vaping could get an entire generation addicted to nicotine. Adams will be at MD Anderson to discuss his concerns today at noon.
How much time have we spent trying to get people off nicotine?
I know.
Off cigarettes, and this is not necessarily safe.
I know, and we always hear people saying that this helped them to quit, but it's just become so appealing to children with all the different flavors and everything.
Sure.
So it's certainly becoming a concern among them. Now, nearly two-thirds of women in their childbearing years are actively trying not to conceive. That's according to a new federal report. Sterilization was the most common method, followed by the birth control pill, implants, and IUDs. Contraception was most common among older women. The numbers include women between the ages of 15 and 49. A new study is looking at why candy in the checkout aisle often ends up in your cart, no matter how well you stick to your shopping list.
So dangerous.
It is dangerous. Supermarket chains in the UK actually started limiting what can be displayed in checkout aisles, and they saw an immediate reduction in candy, chocolate, and potato chip sales, because it's always so tempting right there at the end.
Man.
That was compared to stores that offered healthier choices, right. By the way, if you're standing in line. Now, it's not clear whether sales of gossip magazines increased when the candy disappeared.
Just read them until checkout.
Yeah, so it's like, are you actually grabbing things because it's convenient or just because it looks tasty?
Yeah.
Both.
And if you plan on canoodling under the mistletoe, there may be some holiday foods and alcohol that you should avoid. The secret behind bad breath and what you can eat to combat it, coming up at 6:40.
Or not eat, yes.
Yeah.
Yes, exactly. I'll tell you all about it in about an hour.
Canoodle away.
Canoodling.
One of my favorite words.
But I always wonder if people know how bad the breath is. Like, if you've got that breath, they don't know, right?
If they knew.
I feel like I know when I've got it, but.
If they knew, they would chew gum.
Would they?
You would think so.
Oh, you would hope so.